Information Station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground, your weekly look at what's happening on board the International Space Station. I'm Josh Byerly. Flight controllers are still looking into what caused one of the station's two coolant loops to shut down this week. These loops circulate ammonia outside the station to keep the electronics cool. They suspect a valve didn't work the way that it was supposed to. The crew is fine, and we'll keep you updated as Mission Control figures out how to fix the issue. Meanwhile, Orbital Sciences is getting ready for its Cygnus to head to the station. It'll be taking about 2,700 pounds of cargo up to the crew. If you live anywhere from South Carolina up to Massachusetts, make sure you look up because you'll be able to see the launch. For the latest updates on the launch date and time, log on to nasa.gov/station. In station science, the crew has been looking at how circadian rhythms are impacted by living in space. Anyone who has suffered jet lag knows the importance of staying on a normal schedule. This study takes a look at whether different exercise or even different lighting inside the station could help the crews adapt. Scientists are also looking deep into the eyes of the astronauts. Over the last couple of years, researchers have noticed that some of the crew's eyes are affected by being up in space. The eye tends to change shape, which could change vision. So now they're using multiple ways to study the crew's eyes and figure out what's going on. The hope is that these changes can be better predicted and solved, especially when we talk about longer journeys to an asteroid or Mars. Do you think you can train like an astronaut? Mike Hopkins is giving you the chance. Mike is a big fan of physical fitness, and during his time aboard the station, he's been sending down workout tips and other fitness info. If you'd like to take a look or join in, just check out facebook.com/trainastronaut. Elliot Davis tweeted us this question: what time zone do the astronauts on board the ISS operate in? Well, good question. Since Mission Control Houston is in Texas and the Russian Flight Control Center is in Moscow, we split the difference in the time zones. So the crew and the ground teams are all on Greenwich Mean Time or Universal Time. So the crew ends up waking up around midnight Central Time and going to bed around 3:30 p.m. If you have questions or comments you want to send to us, just use the hashtag #SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.